This episode is supported by CuriosityStream. This is a meter, but it's not the meter. The meter isn't a physical object, locked away in some secret vault somewhere. The meter is a math problem. Take the distance light travels in 1 second and cut it into this many chunks. That's how we define a meter. But why that number? Why not this many chunks? Or this many? It's the fundamental unit of the metric system, a unit built into the very foundations of physics. So surely something in the basic laws of the universe explains why a meter is a meter. But that's not the case. The real story is full of discovery, deception, and a lot of people getting their heads cut off. 1789. The French people have a lot of problems with the monarchy, and Louis was gonna hear about it. In their airing of grievances, the people included demands to fix France's system of weights and measures. It was a confusing mess. Every town and trade basically measured things how they wanted. This was not a new problem. The ancient Egyptian cubit was said to be the length of a man's arm, and the English inch was three pieces of barley laid end to end. But whose arm and whose barley? In France, a pound of bread sometimes really was lighter than a pound of lead. Its people were using some 250,000 different measures, which made trade difficult and cheating easy. A pint of beer in Paris, two-thirds the size of a pint in Saint-Denis. If ever there were an injustice worthy of revolution, it was that. France's revolutionary spirit wanted united and equal measures for a united and equal people. But French savants, being the enlightened dudes they were, set their goal even higher. A universal measure for all nations derived from nature itself. Rulers, who needs them? The basic unit of length would be called the meter, and all other units derived from that. The divisions of those units would be decimal and given prefixes from Greek and Latin, so the whole thing would sound old and important. All that was left to do was invent the meter. One smart choice was the length of a pendulum swinging once per second. Thomas Jefferson even agreed to make some measurements and join America into this new metric system. Problem solved, right? Wrong. First, they had to agree on the length of a second. Some French savants wanted to throw out the day we use and replace it with a decimal day. Since no one could agree on a second, the pendulum meter was dropped. In its place, a meter defined as 1/10,000,000th the distance between the North Pole and the equator, along a meridian passing through France. England and the USA refused to accept a measure based on a French line, and, well, we all know how that turned out. In 1791, two men set out to make the meter. Their plan, measure latitude at the ends, then meet in the middle. Do a little multiplication, and you've measured the Earth. Unfortunately, they don't make 1,000-kilometer tape measures. Instead, Méchon and Delambre would mark a series of triangles across France. Walking off just one side of a triangle in the north and south, they could use those angles to calculate the length of every link in the chain, proving trigonometry is good for something after all. This was their tool. The repeating circle was two telescopes mounted on a ring. Zero in on two distant markers and measure the angle between them. But a single measurement was guaranteed to have some error. The repeating circle was rotated and remeasured, each time adding the new angle to the previous sum. Divide by the number of measurements, and the average angle would be more precise than any single measurement. These would be the most precise surveying measurements ever attempted, giving the world an error-free meter. Unfortunately, as soon as they set off, things in France went to double hockey sticks. Revolution was in full swing. The king was in jail, then dead, and France was at war with basically everyone, but especially Spain. In city after city, people assumed the scientists with the funny tools were royal spies, and each time they barely kept their heads. But after 7 years of struggle, the triangles were connected. In 1799, pages and pages of calculations were reviewed. The distance from the North Pole to the equator was determined, and a platinum meter was cut, 1/10,000,000th as long. Mankind finally had a definitive universal measure derived from nature. There was just one problem. The meter was and is wrong. To calculate the meter, they needed an accurate measure of Earth's curvature. Since Newton, scientists knew Earth's cross-section was an ellipse, not a circle, but the results of the meter expedition claimed Earth was twice as squished as they had thought. It wasn't, they just picked a bad line to measure. Worse, the curve isn't smooth. This was a big discovery, but it also invalidated the whole premise of the meter. Earth is too irregular to be its own measure. But rather than admit 7 years of wasted time, the new triangulations were combined with older measures measures for Earth's curvature. And the meter ended up being an estimate, a physical object, the opposite of what it was supposed to be. Plus, it turned out one of the guys fudged a bunch of his data, but that's a whole other story. Of course, today we don't measure the meter based on a hunk of metal. Or do we? In 1960, the meter was redefined as a number of atomic wavelengths, but that was calculated to match the old platinum bar. And in 1983, the meter was redefined again as the distance light will travel in 1,299,792,458 of a second. But that number was also chosen to match the old hunk of metal. Based on satellite measurements of Earth's average curvature, today we know that 10 million meters from pole to equator would leave you about 2 kilometers shy. The meter was invented as a perfect ratio, but even our meter, based on the speed of light, carries an old error, 2/10 of a millimeter shorter than it should be. Of course, it's still a meter because we say it is, but if you shake the basic laws of the universe, a meter doesn't fall out. It's just another invention. But as inventions go, it was revolutionary. Stay curious. Hey guys, if you are like me, you probably never get enough videos and documentaries full of facts and educational stuff about basically everything. If that sounds like you, then you might like this. This week's episode was brought to you by CuriosityStream. It's a streaming service full of documentaries and nonfiction titles from great filmmakers, including some exclusive originals. I really liked one called Deep Time History. It's about how events way back in the history of the universe influenced modern times through physics, chemistry, and geology. It reminds you that history is older than we think. My CuriosityStream gives you unlimited access starting at just $2.99 a month, but for you guys, you can get the first 2 months free if you sign up at curiositystream.com/smart. That promo code SMART will be good for 60 days to check it out for free. They've got apps for lots of platforms, it's available in 196 countries, and it's a cool way to satisfy your curiosity. All right, see you next week. The next time someone gives us Americans a hard time for being the last country not in the metric system, you send them this video. Your meter ain't so special. My car gets 40 rods to the hog's head, and that's the way I likes it. Thanks. Please subscribe.